fucking thing sucks!
In 5, 4, 3.
They see the vote is just a screen of hope. You acting like we got control over who gets chosen. I think it's a joke. The president's on dope, sipping coke. He's just a puppet, a patsy, taking orders from a bolt to the mast. He was dancing with the devil, so we can't ever trust. You got us by the balls, power, blood, money, and lust. Just take control of yourself. You know that change is a must. The initials of the U.S. is us. Before you join the military, see what the war's about. We got a lot of dirt to clean in our house.
The president's committed treason. It's the reason we stand and we fight. Through the darkness and the light, the government lied.
Soldiers died. In the fire of war, they got burnt. They had to learn the hard way. The freedom isn't free, so they paid the price
with their life. And now you miss them. Some are still missing. This ain't the Christian coalition. I'm a child of the earth. They study this knowledge without a need of a church. Of course, I thank the Lord, but no thank you for the war. All of what we fighting for. It's the rich against the poor. Missiles flying overhead. Bodies coming home dead.
Okay, folks. Permanent Patriot here. Let's cut the bullshit. This sign does not mean rock and roll, and it doesn't represent the Texas Longhorns or any other animal. Well, folks, all you do when you give this kind of symbolism is you give evil more power to manifest and come in, just more power. While it pushes out the good and the light. And if you think that, you know, this is good for your future, or, you know, you just really don't care or whatever, well, think of what it's doing to people around you and doing to your country. Now, I don't even like getting into this shit, but that's what it means, okay? And everybody seems to be doing it. Now, folks, either this is something that needs to seriously fucking be discussed, or I have stumbled upon the greatest coincidence in history for about the 25,000th time. And see, he's all throughout the 2005 inauguration. See, he was all worried through his first one because of 9/11. Now that he knows he got away with it, he's dancing around. He's happy. That must be why he turned into a bumbling, stumbling, moronic drunk. And was crying and whining about the demons. Had the Secret Service come and take him like a little baby. More than a few times. And look, these guys hate each other so much, they're on the same fucking team. Folks, I'm telling you, every fucking government is working together. Do not let them fool you. Come on, man. There's your kids. It all started with Disney, folks. It's fact. Walt Disney and the CIA started all this shit. And the fucking cartoons with the pyramids and the damn devil signs. Look, everybody. It's everywhere. It's everywhere. And you keep letting it in by allowing this shit. Look at this, man. Come on. Unreal. Right in front of your fucking face. There's a big penis. And you don't even know it. It is shit. Real fucking cute. There's all your moral leaders and role models, icons that you, your kids, look up to. So, you know, before you start praising a person, you might want to look into them a little bit. I would suggest that one. And since I can't take none of this fucking shit, I just wanted to show you this Zodiac shit. Because I'm going to be getting into it. Well, not this so much as, because I like true crime too. You know, whodunit. Serial killers. How many serial killers do you think are on the streets of America right now? Estimated. Most of you probably say 2 or 3. And you are correct. If you add a couple of zeros to the end of those numbers. So look, it was the Federal Reserve Act of 1913 that enabled the bankster criminals to start and finance both sides of World Wars 1 and 2, and not 3. It caused the Great Depression. They cause boom and bust cycles. They are thug criminals. And we depend on them. I'm fucking real. So we're gonna be getting into some true crime shit soon, but you know, I don't like talking about this shit. That's what we got her for. You want anything like that? Go see her. Check out the video right here, for instance. And once again, she's also done the same thing I did. She's come up with the most biggest coincidence in history for the 25,000th time. Can you stand it? Coincidence is all around. All around. Enjoy the show.
Hi everyone, this is Lisa Haven, and the rise of an ancient evil has reared its ugly head on a scale never before witnessed. Now, what is this ancient evil that has revived itself? Well, back in the late 1960s, around 1966, Anton LaVey, their leader, resurrected or erected the Church of Satan. And ever since that erection, it has been growing like wildfire all across America, and not just in America, but in other countries as well, from Mexico to Africa and Nigeria and beyond. Now, you've probably heard of Anton LaVey by now. Obviously, he's gone and passed on and likely in hell. But that said, what I want to do today is really delve into how much they have stuck their tentacles into our culture and how it is impacting it. Because I think what we are failing to see is the future of what this could bring to our country. And while the Church of Satan is exponentially growing, their members are growing, I think it's a real threat. Especially morally speaking, because as immorality degrades and goes down the toilet, more crime increases. So this is something that we need to keep aware of. And I think it's not something we need to push under the rug, but every couple years or so, I think it's important to do a report on what is happening with the Church of Satan and other occult organizations in order that we can get a real picture of how things are. We know that they've already attempted to lift up a Baphomet statue in Detroit. They attempted one in Oklahoma, and I'm going to show you reports on that. Also other places, anywhere that there is Christian Christianity stuff. They want to put it right next to it. So it's a direct attack on Christianity. Now, everyone has the right to worship whatever they want. If they want to worship a rug, if they want to worship the earth, if they want to worship Satan, if they want to worship God, freedom of religion. That's what freedom of religion is about. It's not about stomping out one over the other. And this is what we are seeing with Christianity. It's just really being stomped on. You can pray to other gods, but you can't pray to Jesus. You can't pray directly to him. And this is something that I think is raising up a lot of red flags. So I think the best thing to do is just to delve into this report. All right, so for starters, let's check out the Church of Satan website. As you can see, they have their lovely pentagram here, and here is their home page. Welcome to the official website of the Church of Satan, founded in 1996 by Anton LaVey. Obviously, somebody has stepped up to take the place, but here you can see some pretty wretched pictures there. But let's go back to about the organization. A few things that I want you to know as we're digging into this is they don't really list their membership. They believe that they should never give out their exact number of members so people can quantify them or qualify them based on their if they're big or if they're small. In other words, don't know how much power we have behind the wheel, so to speak. Neither do they tell you exactly where their locations are. You can kind of Google it and call the main office to find one. But to have a map of all the locations, while that doesn't really exist, kind of falls along the same lines of why they don't put membership. They don't want you to know their true size. Now, guesstimated numbers have been put out. I'm going to show you those. They're somewhere on my list here in a moment. But here's just a few of the churches of Satan near, one maybe near you, but they're all across America. This one's in Cleveland, Ohio. This is a Facebook page of the Church of Satan. And I'm going to go through these rather quickly. Here is another one on the Church of Satan, Washington, D.C. Here is one, and I believe this one is in Alabama. Here's another one, Queen Creek, Arizona, New York City, the Church of Azazel, Houston, Great Church of Lucifer, opening on Halloween, Church of Satan, another one, and this one, Las Vegas, Nevada, obviously there, and Richmond, Virginia. This one is in Richmond, Virginia. Down at the bottom here, I can't let me fix that screen. There we go. Richmond, Virginia there as well. So kind of all over the place, but this is their official website with information. Here is another one, City Guide. This is members of Mexico. Negro cult believe the devil will protect them. This is on vice.com. This is a disturbing image here of a woman who slashed her back. You can see the beer and the alcohol they've left to their demon god there, Satan. But kind of gets into more detail here. Here is more of the paraphernalia, I would say, that they're leaving in worship of Satan. So this is the kind of stuff that, you know, we're seeing with the rise of this satanic church. Now, the list of churches that I showed you, here's another church. This is a traditional Church of Satan. This is Robert Frey's, and he's theist Satanism. Lovely picture there, isn't it? Here is another one, Iglesia de Satan. This is in Mexico. And it talks about, you know, their Church of Satan, as you can see here as well. So these are kind of all across the country, all across globally as well. And I didn't show you even a pinch of the amount of them, but I just wanted to show you some so you get the general idea. Now, here's a report put out by Daily Mail, which I thought just, it's disturbing. The blood prompt from a still beating heart is the purest form of energy. Ugh. Inside the horrific keyword, Mexican Satanist black mask. And here is some of the imagery from Daily Mail on this black mask. You can see the sacrifice of animals here, just kind of done out in the open. Very sick and disturbing. Here is some information that I found on the forbiddenknowledge.com. And this is the only place at the time that I could find about how big the size of the Church of Satan is, because like I said, they do not print their membership. They don't take numbers. They don't give you that information, but they're estimating in America alone, they could be up to as many as 20,000 members. Now, may I suggest that that number is likely larger? This report was put out, I believe, a few years ago. There's not a full date on when this was published, but it's a start for where we're at. But definitely, I think it's definitely bigger than that number. But that gives you an idea of what we are dealing with. Here is another one. As ex-Christians and whatnot, I mean, anybody who openly worships Satan, I can't say that that's a good thing. It's disturbing and sick on so many levels that anybody would want to openly worship Satan. Somebody who is demonic and evil to the core. Now, I put this report out back in December 22nd, 2015 here, and literally it's disturbing, but it's Satanists performing their first ever sanctioned state ceremony, and this was on the courthouse lawn or the Capitol building in Lansing, Michigan. And it was literally state sanctioned ceremony. And if you haven't gotten a chance, I'm going to leave the video to this below. This is the video here. You can hit play and watch it, but they deliver their satanic speech live there and put it up for all to see. But it's really, really disturbing. I might, you know, warn you on that, but that's one. Here is another one, how the Satanic Temple forced Phoenix lawmakers to ban prayer. They wanted to hold another, satanic invocation before an upcoming sitting meeting in Phoenix. And instead of allowing them to do that meeting, they canceled prayer altogether. So Christian prayer, any prayer was eliminated, and they basically got what they wanted. Instead of, you know, either way, it's kind of, you know, you put them in a rock and a hard place. You let us pray and let us praise our God, or you don't do your prayer at all. And Phoenix, in this case, chose not to do the prayer anymore. But just, it is an attack on Christianity. Here is the Satanic Temple of Detroit. I'm going to leave a link for that as well. Here is revolvermag.com, and this is famous members of the Satanic Church, and I'm going to show you, obviously, Marilyn Manson here. He's a riot, Jane Mansfield, in that one. Liberace here. Sammy Davis Jr. Davis throws a horn. That's in his movie Poor Devil. Balls Mahoney. Soft Cell Main Man. David Vincent. Derek Grant of Alkin Trio. David or King Diamond. And these are just some of them. And that's King Diamond again there. So thought this was interesting. I'll leave a link for that for you to check it out. Here is another report, and this was listed or reported on time.com. Hundreds gather for the unveiling of satanic statue in Detroit. This is where they put up a big Baphomet statue. Here we have that here. The bronze monument was unveiled by the Satanic Temple in Detroit on July 25th. Let me show you that image. There we go. That's a little bit better version of it, as you can see there, but that's the image. Here is a look at something. They wanted to build another one of these in Oklahoma back in 2014. Thankfully, I guess that didn't come to fruition, but here now they are looking for a brand new home because of Oklahoma's ruling to take down, I guess they took down the Ten Commandments. Therefore, now they want to put their statue somewhere else that has Ten Commandments. And that reports on Channel 4 News here. So there it is. Things are getting nuts. Just wanted to bring all of that to you to show you how much the organization has grown since the 1960s. To have them only in one area and then have an explosion across basically all 50 states. If you live in a state, Google, you know, Satanic Church of Iowa, Satanic Church of Texas, Satanic Church of Arizona, and you're gonna be quite shocked about what you find. I highly encourage it. But all this to say that as Christians, we need to understand there is a real spiritual war. There's an attack on Christianity coming, and I believe it's already here. And not only that, but there's attack on our immorality. Our government and those in leadership want the demoralization of our culture because we're more pliable, we're more brainwashable when we're not in the family line. And this is what the Illuminati, those at the very top, Satan himself wants. This is why many elitists go to satanic groups like the Bohemian Grove or in the Skull and Crossbones organization or in the Illuminati or in Freemasonry. It's those organizations that are breeding grounds for Satanism, and here they're out in the open like never before. So this ancient evil has been around this whole time. However, it is rearing its ugly head and being more prominent in our culture via the Satanic Church. And I think we need to remember how bold they're getting today. And, you know, just take into consideration, as the days of Noah, so are the days that we're living in today. So just be ready. Be ready in your schools because they're already attempting to issue pamphlets. I know the Church of Satan wanted to issue a coloring book of satanic pentagrams and information for children in a school in Florida. To promote, quote, all religions, their religion included, even though it hails the demonic force itself. Pretty crazy. Crazy days that we're getting into, and I don't foresee things getting better unless there's some kind of a major revival. Anyhow, wanted to bring you the latest on that. This is Lisa Haven signing off.